In this video, I'll discuss device sensors, jailbreaking, and MDM system requirements. A centralized mobile device management solution, or MDM, should be able to manage many aspects of a mobile device, including sensors. Sensors are built into mobile devices, and they exist so that they can detect things like motion, orientation, and positioning of the mobile device, which gets used by various apps. MDMs should also be able to manage accelerometers. Accelerometers are used to identify the orientation of the mobile device. So for example, this might be used for GPS or for compass type of apps and so on. We can also centrally manage whether or not the camera is enabled, the microphone, network settings for the various types of networks a mobile device can connect to, as well as whether or not we want to enforce storage encryption. So this should be done from a centralized solution in the enterprise, such as using an MDM. There are many vendor MDM solutions out there. Here in System Center Configuration Manager, we can take a look at our compliance settings, and down under our configuration baselines, we can see any items that have been configured previously. For example, here I can see I've got a Toronto Android baseline, which I can apply to Android devices to lock them down centrally. So I'm going to go ahead and double-click on this configuration baseline, and I'm going to go into my Toronto Android restrictions, and I'm going to go under the compliance rules. Here I can see any configured rules, such as requiring a password on mobile devices, the minimum password length, the password complexity, and so on. However, if I click the new button at the bottom, here I can see a collection of all of the settings that can be applied, in this case specifically, to mobile Android devices. So whether or not we allow the browser to be used, whether JavaScript or plugins are allowed to be used, also whether application stores can be used to install software on the mobile device, whether Bluetooth is enabled, and so on. In the enterprise, we also have the option of disabling devices in various ways, such as is in the case with geofencing. Geofencing applies when a mobile device enters or exits a boundary. Now, with this, for example, we might enable mobile notifications so that the end user is aware that they are entering or leaving a certain area geographically. Or, for example, a device might even be completely disabled. So, in the case of mobile devices used specifically for work purposes within an environment, such as in a hospital or on a plant floor, maybe when that device leaves a certain area, it gets disabled for safety reasons. We can also enable or disable specific features in a device in conjunction with geofencing instead of completely disabling device.